Hello everyone, today we will learn how to start recording using Jmeter. So first of all, we'll open Jmeter and then we'll add basic components which are required. So here is a template option. When we click on the template option, it gives us which template we want to select. There are multiple options are available over here, like recording with ThinkTime, JDBC load test, Initial sampler and many more. So for now we'll use recording template. So it will provide us all the basic component which are required for recording purpose. Okay, so this is the recording controller, this is the test script recorder from where we need to start the recording. So we are using port number 8888 for proxy setting, so that Jmeter can record all the traffic which is going from the computer. So now what we'll do is we'll put the same port setting in the browser which we are going to use for recording purpose. So go to setting, advanced setting, proxy setting, and over here we'll pass that same port number we are using. Manual proxy, yes. Address, localhost, and 8888. Save the setting. Now close it. Now one more thing is there. What is the target controller? We can use any there are multiple options under which we want to record all the requests. So we'll use recording controller. Okay, so that is under, this is the recording controller, that is on thread group. Okay, and put each group in a new transaction controller. We'll use the setting, put each group, so that when a single action will perform, all the requests corresponding to that action will come under a single transaction controller, single controller. So that's why we'll use this particular value. Let's start the recording. Look some feature of this application. Allow access. Sometime we can get that message, so we need to just allow that. Now this is the screen which shows that Jmeter has generated a certificate. So in case we are using HTTPS application, secured application, what we need to do is we need to add this certificate which is just generated by Jmeter into our browser certificates, and then Jmeter will be able to record all the traffic moved by HTTPS application. Okay, so now you see there is some data is displayed over here, HTTP. So we can ignore these two data because that is of no use for us. Now we'll hit our website, we'll launch the website. This is a demo website which we are going to use. Yes, so launch has been done. So what we will do now is under this particular controller we have let me check what our requests has been generated under this particular Yes. So you can see requests are coming under this 7 number controller. So we'll rename it to as a launch. Or you can say launch application. So it will help us to identify things in later stage. Okay. After this, what we will do? We'll log in into the application. This is the username and password. We have put click on sign in button. Yes, now you can see application is signed in. So now I need to identify which particular request is there which I used. No, so this must be in the 41 only. Yes, you can see this is the request. So what I'll do is I'll give name this 41 as a login into application. After login has been done, what we will do is we will select the specific value whatever we want to select, date, all the specific details, and then click on continue. Now give this corresponding to this, give the name to corresponding controller, that is a flight finder. Flight finder, you will see all the details are here, round trip, London, Paris, everything is there. So now we have some options to select. Let's say I'll select Blue Sky Airline 361 for departure and 632 for return. Let's continue. Now after flying fighter, yes, this is the next quest, so I'll make it select flight. Okay, so over here I have selected my flight. So give the required data, test 1, give any random number, any number will work over here because this is a sample website. Billing address, delivery address, everything is there. Now we just click on the secure purchase and here we go, ticket has been booked. So what we will do is we'll give this particular controller transaction name as booking confirmation. And then after that we can go sign off. And we can give this transaction as a name of sign off. This is one thing. Other thing is sometime we have some unnecessary request came into the picture. Like, okay, let me first stop the recording. From here I just need to stop the recording. And after that I need to go to again proxy setting for the browser to remove that localhost and proxy setting to make our browser working normally as expected. Proxy setup, open proxy setting, just mark it as a off. That's it. Okay, so now we need to do one more thing to complete the recording part. Sometime these are the unnecessary requests which generated during recording time. So what we need to do is we need to remove this type of request. Please go there, remove them. Over here again you will see these three are the unnecessary requests, so we can again remove them. The same way we'll go all the steps we need to verify. I am just checking the server name, IP address, port number, protocol, and from there I will get the information that okay, this is a junk data, so I need to remove that. Okay, so login into application. Again, I have a set of junk data. Login. This is again a junk, so remove it. This is a reservation part, and this is a junk data again. This one, this is again a junk set of data. Yes. Okay. This is a okay. One part is complete. Second, we need to save this recording. Let me get one folder in the desktop only. YAML1 book flight. Underscore version 0. This is the version 0, so that whenever we make any changes, we can make changes in its version. Second thing is, in our next session, when we will go for correlation recording, this view result tree will help us, because when we recorded this complete scenario, result of all the requests came here under view result tree, under test script recorder. So it will help us to correlate the data, what data to correlate, how to correlate, everything. It will help us on doing that. So in our next session, we'll learn all those things. So I hope you like the video, and key purpose of watching this video is also fulfilling. So that's all for today. In the next session, we'll learn correlation, parameterization, and any other modification which is required in Jmeter. That's all. Thank you.